shock stopped you from rejoicing. He said, why are you rejoicing in that situation? You tell him, because the God of my salvation, he wants me to rejoice. He wants me, amen, to let the enemy know that you have nothing in me. When my prayers are hindered, something is in me that's got to go. And the only way you're going to find out is through prayer. When God reveals that thing to you, it's up to you to get rid of it. I can't follow you home. I don't know what's on your phone. I don't know what conversations you have. I have no idea. But God knows, hears, and sees all things.
Yes, he does.
You got to give it to him. And once you give it to him, you got to believe God. See, the enemy, he will cause fear and doubt. He said, there's nothing to it. But if I've been abiding in the word of God, he said, ask what you will. Ask what you will. Ask whatever it is that you will. If you're doing good, ask the Lord. If you're not doing, repent and say, Lord, I'm sorry. I was following my own self. Flesh was leading me and not the Spirit of God. That's all you want is repentance. Saints of God, I'm telling you, I'm so excited this morning. And what the Lord is beginning to do, as he moves on our hearts, as he moves in this place, listen to me. Don't listen to the devil and say, don't just sit there. Ain't nothing to it. God has been too good to you to sit down on it. God is too good for you not to raise your hand. God is too good for you not to clap your hands. God is too good for you not to say, Lord, I just want to thank you, Lord. Let the praises flow from your lips.
Hallelujah.
I want to thank God. Sister Melanie said, I want to find out who it was. Just tell them one thing.
See,
don't worry about that. Tell the Lord. The Bible said the wealth of the wicked is laid up for who? I'm not saying the man is wicked. He did a noble thing to you. You tell God thank you. Because God moved on his heart. The enemy wants to keep you in debt. The enemy wants to worry. But watch what God has done for you. You have a right to praise God. Rejoice in the God of your salvation. That's a testimony. Don't worry about who it is. You tell them God did it. And say, God, to the man that did it, I thank you for it. God will place it on his heart for doing this thing. He knows who you are. But you don't know who he is. I know who God is, and God knows who I am. Rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say, rejoice always.